Hello everyone, how are you? I hope all of you are keeping good. In this video, we are going to discuss about forces. Before we go in detail about forces, we'll discuss about some of the very important keywords. First is physical quantity. Physical quantity means anything which we can measure, that is known as physical quantity. For example, length, mass, time, temperature, pressure, force, all these things we can measure either manually or with the help of some instruments. So they are known as physical quantity. Next is unit. What is unit? Unit is a standard which we use to represent any physical quantity. For example, meter, hour, second, centimeter, Kelvin. All these are units. You know why we need them? Why we need unit? You can understand this in this way. Suppose you are going to market and you have to purchase something. Go to shopkeeper and say 10 rice, 5 milk, 2 cloth. You know what he will think? Something like this. If you say 10 kg rice, 5 liter milk, 2 meter cloth, then easily he will understand what you are asking. So that is the demand and that is the use of unit. We use unit to represent any physical quantity. Next is formula. Formula is a mathematical relationship between physical quantities. Next is definition. Definition is a statement which explains the meaning of a word or a phrase. For example, what is the definition of a force? How do we say this? Force is a push or a pull. So this is the definition of a force. These four keywords you need to remember because you are going to hear that in each and every chapter. SI unit of force is Newton. We can represent force with the help of force arrow. The length of the force arrow represents the size of the force and the direction of the force arrow represents the direction of the force. To draw a force arrow, we should know about scale and direction. In general, for scale, we can assume 10 Newton is equal to 1 centimeter. So if you have to draw a force arrow for 50 Newton, you can take the size of the arrow 5 centimeter. These are the directions, north, south, east and west. Now we'll see some examples for force arrow. 50 cm towards east, 100 cm towards west, 30 cm towards north and 70 cm towards south. Force from one object can act on another object even though they are not in contact. These type of forces are known as non-contact forces. For example, gravitational force, electrostatic force, etc. But there are some forces which come in action when they come in contact with each other and they are known as contact force. For example, friction force. After watching this video, you should be able to answer these questions. First, what is a force? And what is its SI unit? Second, what is the difference between contact and non-contact force? Third, what is the meaning of physical quantity and a unit? Fourth, how do we represent a force?